I'm here at the Space Life Sciences Lab in Florida to talk with NASA and CASIS researchers about amazing science happening up on the International Space Station. Each experiment aboard the International Space Station started off as just an idea, and your ideas can become real-life experiments up in space, too.
How do we keep bones strong on long-duration exploration missions so that when we get to Mars, we are not at risk for breaking bones, and when our astronauts get home, they're healthy? My name is Liz Warren, and I'm a scientist with CASIS, the Center for the Advancement of Science in Space. Just about everything we understand about science changes a little bit when you take it to a microgravity environment like the International Space Station. Life as we know it has evolved with one constant, and that's gravity. So the way our bodies look and function are all pretty much related to fighting gravity. Our bones are strong and our muscles are strong to fight gravity. So when we go to space, all of these systems kind of change and acclimate a little bit because they're no longer fighting gravity. Early on, we noticed that bone density was changing, decreasing in astronauts, meaning their bones were getting a little bit weaker the longer that people stayed in space. If you're not using them and applying stress to them, they'll get weaker. They're only as strong as they need to be because it takes energy to keep our bones strong. So it's kind of an energy savings that if you go to space where your bones and muscles will not experience a lot of different types of loads, there's no need to keep up all that muscle and all that bone. So those tend to decrease. And so NASA spends a lot of time and energy investing in what we call countermeasures. A countermeasure is some activity that an astronaut can do to mitigate or reduce those risks from happening or reduce the bone loss. So there's exercise, there's nutrition, there may even be some pharmaceutical countermeasures. The exercise device that we use on the space station that really helps keep bones strong, it's called ARED, the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device. The problem with ARED though is, while it's really awesome, is really pretty big. I don't think we're going to be able to fit it in, say, the Orion capsule or some of our other plans for deep space exploration. So we need to design something smaller, but that works just as well. So there's another factor that may be important in keeping bones strong while we are doing space exploration, and that may involve individual variability between astronauts, so our genes. Some astronauts may be genetically predisposed to have really strong bones and may not be so susceptible to unloading or microgravity. Some astronauts, it may be the opposite. They may be more susceptible to bone loss, and the microgravity environment may exacerbate their bone loss and put them in a bad situation. You know, what are the genes that are involved, and what are the individual variabilities between astronauts, between people, that may make some people really good astronauts for long duration spaceflight and others maybe not so good? I think cell culture is a really fascinating possibility for doing work on the International Space Station. And cells are pretty fun, actually, to grow in culture. They're delicate, but at the same time, they're pretty hardy. And so if you really want to understand what is happening, you have to know what's going on inside the cells. What genes are being turned on? What genes are being turned off? Are there transcription factors that are changed with a different stimulus? All of these things you might want to consider for studying bones in space. There's so much to learn, and there's so much going on, and it's a vastly interesting field. Please join us on this journey of discovery. I'm excited to see what you're gonna learn, and we need you, so please join us.
By entering the Genes in Space contest, your ideas, designed to test questions about how microgravity affects life in space, could be launched to the space station from right here at the Kennedy Space Center. Find out more about how to turn your ideas into real-life experiments up in space.